We want to use the disk method to find the volume of the solid generated by rotating the region bounded by y equals 2.3 raised to the power of x equals negative 1, x equals 1, about the x-axis. So looking at our graph here below, here's x equals negative 1, here's x equals 1, and here's our function y equals 2.3 raised to the power of x. And we're rotating about the x-axis here. And therefore, the bounded region would be this region here. If we rotate this region about the x-axis, it creates this solid here, and our goal is to find the volume of this solid. When using the disk method, or the washer method, it's helpful to sketch a representative rectangle, where if we were to rotate the rectangle about the x-axis, it would give us one disk that would give us an approximate volume to one slice of the solid. As an example, if we were to use this rectangle here and rotate it about the x-axis, it would give us this disk, which would give us the approximate volume of one slice of our solid. Notice that the radius of this disk, or right circular cylinder, would be this length here, which we call r of x, which in this case would just be the function value 2.3 raised to the power of x. And the width of the rectangle would be delta x, which if we think of this as a right circular cylinder, would be the height of the cylinder. So because we have delta x here, we integrate with respect to x. And again, the radius would be the function value 2.3 raised to the power of x. Remember, if we were trying to find the volume of a right circular cylinder, we would use the formula V equals pi r squared times h. If we take a look at the volume formula given here, we can see this formula in our integral. We have the volume equals pi times the integral of big R of x squared, integrated with respect to x from a to b. Here's the pi, R of x squared is the radius squared, and dx or delta x represents the height of the right circular cylinder. So we have all the pieces we need in order to find the volume of this solid using the disk method. The volume is equal to pi times the integral of r of x squared, which would be 2.3 raised to the power of x squared, integrated with respect to x, from negative 1 to 1. Now let's evaluate this integral on the next slide. First, notice how we have powers to powers here, so we'll multiply the exponents and write this as 2.3 raised to the power of 2x. Looking at the integration formula given here below, notice how we'll have to perform u substitution to integrate this, where u would be equal to 2x, and therefore differential u would be 2x dx. If we divide both sides by 2, we can say 1 half du equals dx. So for the next step, let's write this in terms of u, which means we'll leave out the limits of integration temporarily. So we'll have pi times integral of, this would be 2.3 raised to the power of u, but dx is equal to 1 half du, so we have an extra factor of 1 half. So let's write this as pi divided by 2 du. Now let's find the antiderivative and write it back in terms of x. So we have pi over 2. The antiderivative of 2.3 raised to the power of u is given here. We'd have 1 divided by natural log a, or 1 divided by natural log 2.3, times a to the u, which would be 2.3 raised to the power of u, which is really 2.3 raised to the power of 2x, and we're integrating from negative 1 to 1. So now let's write this as pi divided by 2 times natural log 2.3, and I will evaluate 2.3 raised to the power of 2x at 1, negative 1, and then find the difference. So we'd have 2.3 raised to the power of 2 times 1, minus 2.3 raised to the power of 2 times negative 1. So let's write this as pi divided by 2 natural log 2.3 times, we'll leave this as 2.3 squared. This would be 2.3 to the negative 2 power. So let's write this as negative 1 divided by 2.3 squared. So this would give us the exact volume of our solid. Let's also get our decimal approximation. So we have pi divided by 2 natural log 2.3 times 2.3 squared minus 1 divided by 2.3 squared. If we round to 4 decimal places, this would be approximately 9.6200. Since in the 5th decimal place we have an 8, we round up, making this 0.6200. This was a fairly involved integral, so just to make sure we didn't make a mistake, let's go back to the first slide and evaluate this integral here using the graphing calculator. So we have pi times our definite integral, so we'll press math. We're looking for function integration, which is off the screen, looks like it's option 9, enter. Next we're going to enter the integrand, which is 2.3 raised to the power of 2x. Comma, the variable of integration, which is x, comma, lower limit of integration is negative 1, comma, upper limit of integration is positive 1, close parenthesis, and enter. And notice how this does verify our result. We have our exact volume and the approximate volume. I hope you found this helpful.